Hello everyone, I'm Miss Yvette, and today we will be learning how to make bouncy balls. The bouncy ball we will be creating today is made from a polymer. A polymer is a molecule made up of repeating chemical units. In this experiment, glue contains the polymer polyvinyl acetate, PVA, which when mixed with borax has a chemical reaction. For this experiment, we will need two bowls, some stirrers, food coloring, measuring cups, borax, some glue, cornstarch, and some warm water. We will begin by adding a tablespoon of borax into a plastic bowl. Then we will add half a cup of warm water into the bowl. And then you're gonna wanna stir until the borax has dissolved into the water completely. In a separate bowl, add 2 tablespoons of glue. And a tablespoon of cornstarch. Then you can choose which food coloring you want to add into. Then you're gonna wanna stir it with a stir stick. Remember the solution we created earlier with the borax and warm water? Let's add a tablespoon of that solution into the glue and cornstarch. As you are stirring, you will notice that the mixture begins to firm up and become rubbery. At this point, you would want to pick it up and roll it into a ball. If you notice that the mixture is not firm enough, you can add more borax into the mixture. Now that we have created our own bouncy ball and you understand the process of how to make your own bouncy ball, try altering the recipe. In other words, try changing the recipe. Experiment with different ratios of cornstarch, borax, and glue. You'll notice that when you add more cornstarch, it makes a ball that stretches and bends. When you use less borax, it will make a ball that is gooier. And when using more glue, it makes the ball slimier. Thank you for following along. I hope you enjoyed this fun experiment. In December 2022, the Anaheim Public Library was awarded the If Then Grant, built on the mantra, "If we support a woman in STEM, then she can change the world." The If Then initiative is designed to activate a culture shift among young girls to open their eyes to STEM careers by funding and elevating women in STEM as role models, convening cross-sector partners to illuminate the importance of STEM everywhere, and by inspiring girls with a better portrayal of women in STEM. Furthermore, during this grant period, we will create hands-on learning activities and exhibit banners highlighting women from the If Then collection whose work intersects with the STEM and social justice fields. Each banner includes a photo and title, as well as an inspirational quote, STEM work details and social justice influence details in both English and Spanish. All banners are on display at the Haskett Library. Lastly, this project was made possible with the support of the Little Hill Philanthropies and the Association of Science and Technology Centers, ASTC.